I grew up above Broad, around Mitchell Playground. Even though it was depression and everything else like that, we all worked some. I was one of five children.
New Year's Day 1922, Ernest Frederick Hollings came into a world he would change. Educated in the public schools, the Citadel, USC Law School, the Frederick became Fritz to his friends, and his tongue would become legendary.
I don't have to get elected to a blooming thing.
Money is a cancer on the body politics.
The hell with everybody.
Money, money, money.
I'm free at last. Thank God Almighty, I'm free at last.
The Democrat whose words could kick like a mule became governor when he was 36.
I stand here today.
And with George Wallace two states away declaring war on integration, Fritz Hollings made his own very different civil rights history.
We did not have anyone seriously injured or killed. I was the only Southern governor that could say that.
Governor Hollings helped to yank the cloak off South Carolina's Ku Klux Klan, and on his watch, a young man named Harvey Gantt, the future mayor of Charlotte, became the first black student at Clemson.
His influence and his work...
Don Fowler is former chairman of the Democratic National Committee.
And not only did Senator Governor Hollings ensure that it would be peaceful, it worked.
So did the economy.
When I became governor, the problem was to get jobs for the people. Today, the task is to get people for the jobs.
Governor Hollings had a vision for high-tech schools that turned South Carolina into a tech school model for the country.
We all have a mutual challenge.
He balanced the state budget for the first time since 1895, secured a AAA credit rating.
Some 49,000 welfare families and only 19,000, as Dr. Ellis will tell you, participating in the food stamps.
But Senator Hollings would eventually shine light on places where money was mighty scarce.
Just about put a man on the moon now, I think our national goals of hunger and housing will have to be satisfied.
In 1968, feet barely wet in his first term, the freshman senator went looking for poverty.
It's not a surprise at all that we do have poverty, but the housing conditions here are no less than shocking.
His hunger tours changed policy, helped the poor.
We had to do something about it.
Yet days before his Senate retirement in December of 2004, he spoke of a poverty still very much with us.
We have today in America, with the lack of employ, what we have is even more hunger than we had in those early days.
How so?
It's just that people have fallen through the cracks and everything else like that. The churches are doing better, and we've got Meals on Wheels, and they take a lot of the old senior citizens, the shut-ins. We're getting them fed, but a lot of children are still not getting a nutritious breakfast.
Mr. Hollings, as a teacher, I'm deeply concerned about the lack of emphasis on education.
His wife, Rita, carried her childhood nickname, Pizzi, through a 38-year Senate career that was very much theirs together.
From now on, when the public hears the names Graham, Rudman, or Hollings, they'll think deficit reduction.
That set the stage for a whole series of changes which led to the rules in later budget documents, which I suspect were powerful force in reducing the deficit and eventually creating a surplus.
And Fritz Hollings made his own way. The liberal or conservative label never found permanent home on him or his causes. Passion for saving the oceans. Loathing for government red ink.
You add them all up.
He despised a budget off balance.
Surpluses, surpluses, surpluses. Surplus, surplus, surplus everywhere. And growth, growth, and growth, growth. Cut the taxes, cut the taxes, cut the taxes.
It's tax cuts, tax cuts.
I'll jump off the Capitol Dome if this budget is balanced.
And to Fritz, Social Security amounted to government's sacred ground.
The Social Security fund is not broke. It's the government that's broke. We've got $1.5 trillion that they owe us. If they stop spending the surplus, we'd bring in about $160 billion in the next 6 years. We'd have another $1 trillion.
But we've got to do something about that deficit.
That often lonely voice of dissent fueled a political career across more than half a century, arriving at the end with a humor undulled by years.
Well, I've been called everything. The letter to the editor in the hometown paper the other day said that we hope Hollings enjoys his retirement because we sure as hell will.
The laughter, the scythe tongue.
And I don't have to do things that are politically correct.
And the legacy of Fritz Hollings.
I don't think anybody is indispensable. But I think Fritz
comes as close to that as almost anybody I know.
Will echo for generations.